His pass across the formation is picked off, and Aiden O'Connell's going to flush it.
Nobody knows where it is. Now it's centered. Muir with a shot. Scores!
Now down low to Lana McCarthy. Little spin move.
DeLeo of Bedford. She centers. Shot and score.
Aiden O'Connell puts the exclamation point on the game.
Connor down low, trying to get it. Welcome to Sullivan Arena here on the campus of St. Anselm's College. An early afternoon contest between the Pioneers of Trinity and the Bedford Bulldogs. Hi, I'm Harry Kozlowski here. Connor Daniels is going to be helping me out with color commentary. This Trinity team has yet to win a game this year so far, correct?
To start the year, and currently they're coming off a big loss last week from Concord, where they lost 6-2. Trying to find that first win of the season, get the ball rolling, and just get in a rhythm, get going with it.
Bedford, of course, is 1-1. They won an exciting thriller last Wednesday, the game we covered for you against Hanover, 2-1 overtime win with Dom Tagliaferro scoring the winner with just 40 seconds left in the OT period. However, they ran into a senior-heavy and physical Wyndham team on Saturday at the Ice Center in Salem. They lost that one by a score of 3-1. Ready to drop the puck here at center ice. Lobdell against Hurley, and Trinity controls. Saroy sends the puck up the wall. Can't be controlled. Picked up by Tucker Roberto. Tries to get it over to Gupta, but instead it's going to be O'Connor firing it into the Trinity end. Pioneers have it once again, getting forecheck. Bedford keeps the puck in the Trinity end. Pass inside. Intended for O'Connor. He couldn't quite control the puck, but he gets to the point. Here's O'Connor, the wrister. Blockered away by Lubelchik. Pass in the middle. Lobdell hitting, trying to get a stick on it. He's down on the ice. Goes behind the net. Now O'Connor tries to center it again, but it's taken away by the Pioneers. They break out 3-2. This is Maurice up against Gupta. Getting checked by the Bulldog. Loses the puck in the corner. Maurice comes back and gets it behind the net. Trying to push Gupta away. A little physicality there in the corner. Tagliaferro picks it up. Leaves it for Gupta. He tries to get it out of the zone. Back to Tagliaferro. Sends it up the wall. Goes off a Pioneer. And Lobdell sends it in deep onto Lubelchik while the Bulldogs make a change. Puck is fired in to the Bedford zone, taken away there by Hadley. Now Cassidy tries to shoot it up, gets it to Riccio. Riccio chases it into the corner, wraps around the net, gets it behind the goal. Hadley couldn't control it, but here's a chance in tight. There's a shot and a goal. Brian Riccio scores on a give and go from Parker O'Toole at the 13-17 mark.
That was a fantastic move O'Toole?
O'Toole brought the puck in, and it was Riccio finishing it off, number 18.
Riccio, that was a fantastic move, and great finish on the rebound. I think that was a very, very smart play.
Well, they got it off a turnover. Trinity had the puck momentarily, tried to clear the zone, couldn't do it. O'Toole took the puck away, and it results in a goal here. So O'Toole with the assist. Riccio with the goal, number 18. Puck is in the Bedford end. Fired out to Brian Riccio, our goal scorer. He's being checked on the near wall. Held in by Trinity. There's a shot from the point by DeFreitas. Bedford blocks, takes it away. And Dylan Riccio tries to clear. Now Trinity coming right back. Their shot is blocked. Chris Centrino plays the puck, and we get a whistle here. It looks like a high sticking call going against the Pioneers.
Yeah, it was a high stick. We got to keep working on that. Sorry, I'm nerves. Hang on a second.
That's
sorry.
Okay. You're a new guy.
Sorry. First day, guys.
Be cool. No, we're all friends here, man. No pressure. Bulldogs starting out on the Power play in the Trinity zone. It's held in there at the point. There's a shot by Roberto. Goes wide of the net. Over to the near wall. Picked up by the Trinity Pioneers. But Gupta is able to take that away. Gupta fires it in. Picked up by number 9, Saroy, for Trinity. Pass up the wall. Held in by the Bulldogs. Now taken right back. Nope. Bulldogs can still control it. Now it's finally cleared away.
Great clearing effort.
Apparently, whatever the, I guess the high stick was a non-penalty high stick. It was just a face-off in the neutral zone. Teams are at even strength right now.
Yep.
Puck is shot into the Trinity end. Benzia tries to fire it in. Bedford takes it right back. Here's Brady Plant, his shot, blockered high by Lubelchik.
Big save by Lubelchik there.
He's seen quite a number of shots so far, just 4 minutes into the game here. Here's an opportunity for Bedford with a shot on net by Dom Tagliaferro. Followed up by Lubelchik right there. We get a whistle.
I'm amazed by the play of Lubelchik right now. He's been on it all night long, making big saves, quick, staying up on his feet, and making sure he's in on, focused on the puck as it's coming in.
Braden Lubelchik is a experienced goaltender. He makes another save right there on the Bulldogs. O'Connor in the corner sends it down behind the net. And Brennan Walsh now plays it for the Pioneers. He turns it over. Tagliaferro takes it from him. Lobdell lost it in his skates. Taken away now by Trinity. Long lead pass over to 27. Ronzello, he tries to get a shot away. He does. And Tristan Kerr is there. That's the first shot on net Kerr has seen tonight. And he's up to the task. We get a whistle.
That was a good shot on net. That was what you want to do in that situation.
Ronzello had to chase the puck down. The pass went off the wall. He showed some speed, got to it, and was able to get a shot away. Oh, dangerous deflection there in front of the net. Went right by the Bedford goal, so that was a dangerous scoring chance right there. Now from the point, the shot goes wide from Walsh. Still in the zone here. Ronzello tries to hold it in. He lost it in his skates. Finally, Bedford clears it out. Lobdell. Dangerous pass intercepted there by Maurice, but they're going to say offsides. The Pioneer was in the offensive zone.
Well, Bedford's off to a hot start tonight, getting the early goal, getting the ball rolling, and they're keeping pressure up. But I'm starting to see shift in momentum. Trinity's starting to pick up pace, starting to get some plays on that.
It's good that Bedford got the goal early. They haven't really scored a lot of goals this year, really only three. Oh, four counting today. You know, they had the two goals in the overtime game. Then they had the one against Windham. So getting on the scoreboard early is probably something that Coach Jonathan Garrity wanted to see here. Puck goes into the Trinity end, played by the Pioneers. Behind the net goes Leroux. He loses the puck momentarily. O'Toole fighting for it in the corner. A couple more players join the scrum. Pass up the wall to Saluto. His long pass broken up. It goes to Marr, but Marr had to wait for his teammate to get onside. Gives Bedford time to clear the zone. Turnover in the neutral zone by Dylan Riccio. He gets it back. Then cleared away by Kinsella deep into the Bedford zone. No icing there. 9:47 to go. First period. Bedford leads 1-0 on a goal by Brian Riccio early in the contest. Trinity tries to clear. They get it into the neutral zone, but Tucker Roberto winds up. Gets it to O'Toole, or correction, that's number 5, Jack Warble. His shot is blocked. Now Brady Plant fires on net. Lubelchik stops that. Brennan Walsh takes it and gets it to the near wall. That's Venzia. He loses it to the Bedford player. Brody Plant down low. Puck squirts out to the faceoff circle. Here's another turnover. Plant is able to put it on net just wide. Trinity having a little trouble getting the puck out of their end.
They are. Trinity is having a hard time getting out of their end and looking up ice for the next opportunity to transition play out.
There's a backhand by Gupta back into the Trinity zone. Delayed offsides there on Bedford. Trinity once again tries to get out. This time they got a little room to operate. That's Walsh. Fires it in, but Gupta picks it up for Bedford. He goes behind the net. He's got two players around him. takes it off the skate of one of the Trinity players. Now O'Connor skates out, gets it to Lobdell. Lobdell catches up to the puck, sends it down to Tagliaferro behind the net. Tags tried to center it. It got blocked. Now he's in the corner taking a check. Puck squirts right to Lubelchek. He'll put a glove on and we get a whistle with 8:14 to play, 1-0 Bedford.
Yeah, the game tonight so far, it's looking a little bit like it's starting to get chippy. There's a lot of stick checking, blocked shots, and phenomenal goaltending to start this game off.
A little chippy, but nothing like the handover game. I know you didn't see that one, but that was a game of the tinderbox. Both teams are really laying the lumber on each other. I'm surprised there weren't more penalties than that one.
Yeah.
Here's an offside, so the officials let that get away because the player did get the puck out of the zone quickly, and it gets backhanded into the Trinity end. Brennan Walsh plays it, gets it up the wall. Great check there by O'Connor, gets him off the puck, clears it into the zone, and Lubelchek has to leave it there for Walsh once again. Walsh gets away from one forechecker. Long lead pass, tried to get it up to Maurice. That got broken up. Dylan Riccio had it momentarily in the zone. Comes back out. They got to clear out, get onside. The Riccio brothers out on this line. Puck is cleared out by Trinity. Bedford picks it up. Roberto sends it up the wall to Brian Riccio. He just lets it slide into the Trinity end. Clearing attempt. Held in. Shot from the point by Dylan Riccio and caught there by Lubelchek. I think he was trying to get it to, was it O'Toole that was in front of the net there? Might have been. No, that was Brian Riccio's brother. He tried to get the puck to him to maybe deflect it from the point, but he couldn't get a stick on it. So the faceoff to the right of Lubelchek. There's a shot by O'Toole. It's blocked by a Pioneer. Clearing attempt, no good. Gupta holds it in. Saroy tries to get it up the wall, and he does manage to get it out of the zone, but too far for his teammate Kinsella. Instead, Bedford brings it right back. That's O'Toole. Gets a shot on net, comes off Lubelchek funny. He's able to get a backhand rebound try. Bedford still controlling the puck in the end. There's another shot from the point from O'Toole. It goes into the corner. Brian Riccio leaves it there for Dylan Riccio. Waiting behind the net. Gets it to Brian. Now tries to get it to O'Toole on the near wall. Now back to Gupta at the point. He takes a wrister. Blocked by the Pioneers and comes out of the zone. Gupta chases it down. He's got two Pioneers on him. He's got to shake them off. Now turnover in the neutral zone. Brought right back to Bedford. That gets knocked into the neutral zone. 6:02 to left here in the first period. 1-0 Bedford. Finally a shot on the Bedford net goes wide. Kopp gets it to O'Toole. Tries to enter the Bedford zone. There's a shot by Brady Plant that's blocked. Now Trinity coming back the other way. Here's a chance for them. Walsh, they're going to call a tripping call here? Hand is up. This time I think it is a penalty.
Yeah, this is what I believe will be a tripping call.
Nope, they're going to call it a slash, and that's going to go on number 18, I think it is. 19, I'm trying to see the number. No, number 16. Bobby Kinsella is going to go off for 2 minutes here at the 5:42 mark. So if it wasn't bad enough for Trinity, they're getting outplayed here in this game. Now they've got to kill off a penalty.
Yeah, it's going to be tough for them to build confidence if they keep taking penalties as they're transitioning into offensive zone.
Well, maybe they can get a little confidence that they can kill this penalty off. It's controlled by Bedford. Tagliaferro had it, left it there for Lobdell. Over to Cam Hadley. O'Toole takes a shot, high corner, blocked by Lubelchek, held in at the point, and now cleared out of the zone. Here's an opportunity for Maurice of Trinity, gets it over to his partner, fires it wide. That shot by Connor Hurley. So a great scoring opportunity there for Trinity, but they couldn't make that one pay. Bedford comes right back. Brian Riccio pulls up at the blue line, puts his teammate offsides.
Lobdell went ahead of the play, and it's going to be a whistle and a faceoff in the neutral zone.
That was fantastic penalty killing by Trinity to start this off. Deflecting it out of the zone, I'm not sure who it was. Getting it up and out and looking for the play.
I believe it was Maurice getting it to Connor Hurley, number 10. He was able to get a shot away. And fortunately for Trinity, the shot was wide, so Kerr didn't even have to make a save there. Anyway, on the faceoff, Bedford controls. Jack Warble, Tucker Roberto, Gupta. Now an inside pass to O'Connor. He tried to drop it for Plant. Goes out of the zone. Gupta's got to get it back. 1 minute, 7 seconds remaining in the Trinity penalty to Kinsella. And they get the puck and fire it out of the zone. You're right, Connor has been a pretty good penalty kill so far here for Trinity.
It has been. I'm very impressed. And this is what's going to build confidence in a 0-2 Trinity team that's looking for their first win.
Now Jack Warble skates into the Bedford end. He's behind the net. Has some room to operate. Gets it to Plant. Plant, his shot is blocked. Warble controls in the corner. He gets hit. Nobody at the point here. It's going to be a race. Looks like Plant got to it first. His shot gets blocked again. Bounces in front of the Trinity net, but finally cleared away. All the way down to the Bedford end. So another clearing attempt here. Big hit there. Bedford laying out on Anthony Ronzello. He takes a big hit, and I think Bedford just earned themselves a penalty here. A little roughing call.
I believe so. They went a little too aggressive into the boards on that play. You'd like to let up a little bit right before that. But now we'll have some 4-on-4 hockey, and we'll see where this goes for 17 seconds.
Yeah, it's going to be number 15 for Bedford, Ryan O'Connor, who boarded Ronzello, and like you said, 4-on-4 hockey for 17 seconds, and then Trinity gets the advantage. So a good penalty kill for the Pioneers. They control off the faceoff. At the blue line is Walsh. She waits in the faceoff circle, fires a shot, and that's gloved by Kerr. Walsh tried to get him to knock the puck loose there, but Kerr was quick covering it up.
Yeah, it was a good look. He's coming in from the top of the circle, takes a good shot, but great save.
It's the advantage of playing 4-on-4, lots of room, lots of space on the ice for Walsh to move toward the net, so a lot of room there. So now 6 seconds left to the 4-on-4. Puck is knocked back into the Bedford zone. Now Trinity on the power play. Bedford's just going to float it out. Walsh had it momentarily. He had to wait for his man to go onside. Flips it into the Bedford zone. But the Bulldogs take it and flip it all the way down the ice as they can on a power play. 1:30 to go on that penalty to Bedford's Ryan O'Connor for boarding.
Let's see if Trinity can turn something into the rush here and find some offensive firepower up front.
A little bit of confusion at the start, but they're in the Bedford zone now, and they just turn the puck over. They get it back. Here's a shot from Walsh. That goes wide. He wasn't set for that shot. Now Hurley in the corner waits. Bedford in their defensive box. Trinity skating along the blue line. Pass across now to Brendan Walsh. Goes off his skate. Down low to Connor. Connor Hurley, I should say. Puck goes out in front. Sam Maurice had a chance. Couldn't get a stick on it. Now a shot in tight. Shot, score! Trinity on the board on the power play. Anthony Ronzello picks up the rebound, puts it away.
Way to stick with it. Picks up the rebound off of his own skate and puts it right into the back of the net and ties this game up for Trinity.
What was surprising was the room in the slot for Ronzello to get that shot. Usually that Bedford's pretty good at tying up the slot, but he had just a wide open space right there to cruise into the crease, kick the puck to his stick, and put it away and beat Kerr. So we're all tied up at one here with 2:41 to go. Power play goal for Trinity. O'Toole tries to lay into Kinsella instead, but it looks like O'Toole got the worst of it. Now Gupta for Bedford carries it into the Trinity zone. Takes it behind the net. Centering pass, misses everybody. Goes to O'Toole to the point. That shot is wide. Getting to the point is O'Toole. Sends it to the corner. Bedford skating with some urgency here. Gupta holds it in momentarily. Now the puck out of the zone. It's going to be an offsides on Bedford. You know, it's interesting. We saw that the play was heavily in Bedford's favor early in the game. And then all it takes is a power play and an opportunity like that just to even the game up. So even though the ice was tilted in Bedford's favor, it only takes a moment for Trinity to come back and tie the game.
Exactly. Hockey is all about one shot. It's all it takes to get back into any game.
Trinity controls the faceoff in the neutral zone. Now they turn it over in their own end. O'Toole fighting for possession on the far wall. But Ronzello gets the puck back. Now Maurice skates in with some speed, tries to get around. Gupta does, fires a shot. That goes high into the air. Picked up by number 11, Maurice. Sends it to Saroy, but he can't keep it at the point. Backhanded into the Bedford zone. Ronzello, the goal scorer, had it momentarily. Bedford finally comes up with it. And they get it out of the zone. Now here's a race for the puck. O'Toole trying to get to it first. Lubelchik is able to clear that away.
That was a big play by Lubelchik. If he doesn't get there, that's a very dangerous opportunity for Bedford.
Here's an opportunity for Trinity. A backhand by Sam Maurice coming in all alone. And Kerr got the blocker on him. Let's see if we can see that replay. That was a kind of a defensive lapse there by Bedford. You can see here. Gets around the Bedford defender, comes in all alone, but
phenomenal goaltending right there.
They got the blocker saved there by Kerr. Say keeps it at one apiece. About a minute to go here in the first period, all tied at one. Bedford trying to get out of their zone. Broken stick there for the number 12 there, Brady Plant. Shot on net goes wide. Kopp has it for Bedford on the near wall, sends it down low to Tagliaferro, gets it to Warble. It goes by him. The shot there by Cassidy, he kind of fans on it. Now the puck is in the neutral zone, and coming the other way is Kinsella. Fires a shot high, and it's gloved there by Kerr. And we'll get a whistle at 38 seconds.
Bobby Kinsella looks fully confident in his ability out there tonight. He's making moves, making great passes. He's getting pucks to the net. It's what you want to see from not just him, but the entire team of Trinity. You want to see all of them work together and make this happen.
Well,
find that first win of the year.
They're playing a little more confidence here.
They are.
They had a disadvantage early on. Now they're kind of finding their legs. Puck is behind the Bedford net. 29 seconds left in the period. Lobdell sends it into the corner where O'Connor tries to get free, but it hits a Pioneer player. Maurice had a chance. He loses it. Backhand misses Hurley at the point. Goes all the way back into the Trinity zone. Just 10 seconds left, and it's fired right back here. They're going to wave off the icing because it struck a Bedford player up the far wall. Here's an opportunity for Trinity firing a shot. Connor Hurley did, and that's going to do it for the first period. A goal per side. We had an early goal by Bedford. We thought they were going to run away with it, but a power play opportunity for Trinity. Actually, they killed the penalty, and then got a power play afterwards, and they put it away and tied the game up.
They did. Special teams looks awesome from Trinity tonight between the power play, penalty kill. Bedford, I think they're playing phenomenal hockey as well. They are staying aggressive, looking for the next opportunity, and we'll see what the second period has in store between these two hard-fought rivals.
They are rivals indeed. We got about 12 minutes before the start of the next period. If you're tuning in for Bomb Radio with Phil Bruno, the game that show will be on right after the game, maybe about an hour from now. So we got two more periods of hockey coming up. Bedford and Trinity tied at one. You're watching and listening to Bedford Bulldogs Hockey on BCTV and Bedford 105.1. Welcome back to Sullivan Arena here on the campus of St. Anselm's College. Second period action about to begin. And let's give you a recap of the first period. Bedford got on the board first with a goal from Brian Riccio, assist from Parker O'Toole. And then it was Ronzello for Trinity, a power play goal late. And that's where we're at, tied up. Second period underway. Bedford going from left to right. There's a give and go to Lobdell. Just goes wide. It's a skate. Now another attempt on net. Oh, Lobdell almost had a shot at an open net. Couldn't get a stick down quick enough. Trinity coming back the other way. Connor Hurley fires it off the back wall. Gubner tries to play it. Comes out in front. Connor Hurley gets another shot on it. Now Hurley gets the pass, gets it to the point. LaRoe able to fire it from the point. Kicked away by Kerr, now in the corner. Lobdell takes down his man. And here comes the breakout pass. Tagliaferro tried to get it to O'Connor, and instead it's going to be an offsides because O'Connor couldn't control the puck.
Yeah, with the fresh slate of ice out there, it's looking like everybody's moving around pretty quick to start the second period. And it's going to be looks like a very fast-paced transition type hockey game moving into the second period.
Trinity with a couple of pressures early on in the second period. Bedford wins the faceoff. They fire it in. It goes to Dylan Riccio, fires on his own rebound. Lubelchik able to get the pad down just in the nick of time. So great opportunity there for Bedford. Held in at the point is Roberto. It gets cleared to the near wall. Shot from the point by Hadley. Broken up. And now Kinsella clears it out for Trinity. Pass up for DeFreitas. He fires it, goes wide of the Bedford net. Cam Hadley picks up the loose puck, fires it up the wall, and a great breakout here for the Bulldogs. Roberto. Or correction, that was Dylan Riccio. His shot goes high over the net. Now Hadley's shot is blocked, knocked down there by Trinity. Held in at the blue line by Cassidy. Holds it in again. Third time's a charm right there. Brian Riccio able to get a leg on that pass, and it goes all the way to the near side wall. O'Toole gets to the point. Hadley fires a shot, and that's kicked away by Lubelchik. Turnover behind the net. Dylan Riccio, he loses it momentarily. Held in at the blue line. Now we're going to get a penalty here on Bedford. Another penalty. This might be two penalties in a row. First it was O'Toole, who gave a little bit of a cross-check to Jack DeFreitas, sent him into the wall. Then I think another Bedford player came along and finished him off for good measure. But I think there's only going to be one call here.
Yeah, there's only one call here. It is on number two, O'Toole.
So Bedford trying to be a little chippy here.
Yeah, starting to get chippy. Bedford's looking to get on the attack a little bit, get a little more physical, and muck up into Trinity's space a little bit more.
But instead, it's going to be Trinity on the power play. They scored on their last one. 12:52 here left in the second period. Trinity controls, shot on net from the point is deflected away. Now behind the net, it's Hurley. To the point, oh, that gets tipped away by O'Connor. Brendan Walsh has to chase it. Number 12, Brody Plant, is trying to forecheck him a little bit, harass him in his own end.
Great move by Plant.
Walsh finally gets away from him, gets the puck up to number 11, Maurice. Maurice fires a sharp angle shot. Kerr was ready for that. Back up to the point intended for Walsh. It goes off his stick. He's got to go back into his own end to pick up the puck. Bulldogs make a change here. Pass up for Hurley. Broken up. Now Brody Plant again with the forecheck. Maurice comes into the Bedford zone. Broken right up and fired into the Trinity zone. 1:02 left on a penalty on Bedford to O'Toole. Another attempt to enter the zone, broken up at the Bedford blue line. Now Dylan Riccio had it momentarily, killing some time in the Trinity end before firing it in. Dylan Riccio coming back. Now he lost it. Coming in, it's Ronzello's shot. That goes off a leg just wide of the Bedford net. Ronzello into the corner, being watched by Gupta. Goes to the point to Walsh. Now Maurice had to get by Riccio. There's a shot, goes high in the air and bounces out. And Tucker Roberto is able to clear it out. Now Riccio gets his stick on it and gets it on net. Lubelchik had to put it into the corner. Brian Riccio serving as a forechecker here. Just 10 seconds left on the power play, so Bedford doing a solid job killing this penalty off. 3-2-1 penalty expired. Trinity, though, in the Bedford zone. Gupta had the puck momentarily. Now Kinsella tried to center it. Broken up by Bedford. He had number 15, Saluto, all alone in the slot. Now Bedford's attack is broken up there. Ryan O'Connor loses the puck. Cassidy has it in the neutral zone. Bedford's got to get onside. Cassidy comes in, flips the puck behind the net, runs into a Trinity player, but they can't get it out of the zone. Another clearing attempt, blocked by Bedford. Now finally the puck leaves the zone. Cam Hadley to Cassidy. He's got a man on him. Luckily his pass was not intercepted. Tagliaferro up to Lobdell. Here's an opportunity now. Lobdell, high shot. And Lubelchik got it with his glove. It fell down in front of him. He's able to cover it up. We get a whistle.
Bedford's starting to pick up the pace. They're getting more opportunities. They're quick on their feet, staying physical, forechecking, backchecking. They're doing everything you want to see at the moment to get to try to get ahead in this game.
10 minutes exactly left in this second period. We're all tied at one. And Dylan Riccio will take the faceoff here against Chris Centrino. Pioneers win the faceoff. It comes out to the point. Bedford holds it in. Oh, there's a collision. Now Centrino picks up the loose puck off that collision. Fires to a screen. He fired it through Roberto. Luckily, Kurt saw it and made the save. But that was a smart shot there by Chris Centrino, number two. He comes into the zone, and he lines up the Bedford defender to act as a screen when he takes a shot on Kerr. Trinity wins the faceoff, but loses the puck. Breakout pass goes to O'Toole. It's behind him. Then Brian Riccio picks it up and fires it all the way into the zone. Dylan Riccio, he overskates it. Centrino in the corner takes a hit from Brian Riccio. Puck is sitting underneath him. Waiting for the puck to squirt loose. Finally does. Goes out to Venezia. There's a bit of a collision right there. Who's getting a penalty? You can hear the crowd get excited there. I took my eye off the play momentarily. Looks like it's going to be another Bedford penalty. Yes, it is. It's going to be Dylan Riccio, I think. Nope, correction. It's going to be on Trinity. It's Centrino going to the box for that collision. Maybe the official thought he got his arms up on him. I didn't catch the signal.
Yeah, to me it looked like it was a little bit of a high hit. Got his arm out a little too high up, and you don't really want to get it into the area of his jaw or head.
So an elbow call, I believe. Bedford on the power play. They couldn't score on the first one. There's a shot from the point, gloved easily by Lubelchik. That shot coming from the point, courtesy of Cam Hadley. And we get another whistle here. 9:60 left in the second, 1:56 left in the power play. Lobdell ties up his man in the faceoff circle. Bedford controls the puck. Hadley gets it down to O'Toole. Tried to get it across to Tagliaferro. He couldn't get a stick on it. It's broken up. Tagliaferro at the point, holds it in, gets it to Brian Riccio, but it goes off his stick. He's got to go all the way into the corner behind the goal line. Now back up to Tagliaferro at the point. Back down low to Brian Riccio. Brian's got some room now. Cruising along, gets it to O'Toole on the other side. O'Toole back up to Hadley. Back to O'Toole, faceoff circle. Tagliaferro shot, rebound. Oh, what a save. Finally a third rebound and a goal by Bedford. This is going to be number 18, Brian Riccio. His second goal of the day, a power play goal.
That was a fantastic passing play and set up on the power play. He goes for Hadley goes out to O'Toole, and Tagliaferro puts it on net, and the rebound gets potted by Brian Riccio, I believe.
That was Lobdell. It was two really good saves by Lubelchik. First on Tagliaferro, then the rebound by number 10, Lobdell. Finally, Riccio was able to take a third second rebound, a third shot on Lubelchik, and he finally got it past the open net. So it's 2-1 Bedford here. So Riccio with the second goal of the game. O'Toole with the assist, and Tagliaferro gets an assist as well. So Bulldogs now with the lead have the puck in the Trinity zone. Pioneers break out. This is Ronzello. He's the Trinity goal scorer. Chases the puck behind the net. Ties up his man. Puck still on Ronzello's stick. Finally checked away. And Gupta takes it out for Bedford. Too far there for Brody Plant. It's cleared back in for Gupta. Now O'Connor tries to skate across, finds some room in the neutral zone, loses it, gets it back, sends it into the Trinity end, but Pioneers control. Pass up for Ronzello. He can't control it, and O'Connor, a little eager getting into the zone, causes an offside. The lob bell is over the blue line.
So Bedford taking the lead is looking like, sorry guys, that was a mess up on my part. Brain farted.
It's first time out. We understand. No biggie. Face off in the neutral zone here. Ryan O'Connor wins it. Sends it back to Cam Hadley, who goes down the lob bell. Puck rolls into the corner. Played there by DeFreitas. And now O'Connor takes it away for Bedford. He has the puck hit escape, trying to control. He goes down momentarily. He's incidental contact there. Trinity non the breakout. They get the puck up now to Leroux. Kinsella fires it into the Bedford end where Lobdell meets it. Cassidy now in the corner. He's got two Trinity players on him. Finally up to O'Connor. Gets it out of the zone. Here's Tagliaferro. He's got Lobdell and O'Connor. Tagliaferro, shot goes wide. Tried to center it to Lobdell. Lobdell gets it back. Another shot by Tagliaferro, followed by Lubelcik. So, you know, Lubelcik here, even though he's given up two goals, he's seeing a lot of rubber, and he's been solid despite giving up the two goals.
Yeah, he's been active in his crease. He's making sure he's alert, looking at where the puck is always at, and making sure that he can see through all screens as the shots are coming in at him.
And both the goals really were difficult saves to begin with. I mean, he had three shots in a row on the power play goal that he let in, and the other one was a two-on-one breakaway off a turnover. So he's really been keeping the Trinity team in this game, which is 2-1 Bedford right now.
He sure has kept them in this game.
Bedford takes the puck away and fires it back into the Trinity zone. Forecheck there by Dylan Riccio. He's all over his man. Finally a turnover. Tucker Roberto takes a shot through a screen. I think that Kinsella made that save. Or not Kinsella, but Lubelcik. Puck is back in the Bedford zone for Gupta. He gets it up the wall. Now O'Toole off his stick too far. Taken away by Leroux. Leroux takes a hit. There's a backhand by Roberto. And Lubelcik acts like a outfielder there, catching the puck on the fly. Puck is fired all the way into the Bedford zone, but no icing called here. Trinity gets the puck back momentarily. Now they lose it. And here comes Dylan Riccio. Blocker saved by Lubelcik. Kind of a loose rebound picked up by Bedford. Sharp angle shot from the far wall. Lubelcik makes that save on number four, Brendan Kopp, when we get a whistle here with 5:24 left in the second.
Yeah, Lubelcik stayed right with it. He was focused on the play the whole time. Even with all the chaos, everyone falling right in front of him, he stuck right with it.
Bedford leads 2-1. It's going to be Jack Warble on the faceoff against Connor Hurley. Pioneers win that faceoff, and here's an opportunity now for Maurice using his speed. Chase the puck down in the Bedford zone, but can't control it. Bulldogs take it away. Up the near wall. Clearing attempt. It does leave the zone. DeFreitas gets to it. Centrino over to Maurice. He has to drop back to evade the Bulldog check and gets the puck into the Bedford zone. Hadley has it in the corner. There's a scrum on the near wall. Finally bounces out. Hadley takes the puck into the neutral zone, carries it into the Trinity end. Intercepted by Maurice, but he can't control it. There's a quick shot by Kopp. Gets it on net. Cleared away by Lubelcik. Warble in the corner, sends it all the way back for Cassidy at the faceoff circle. Shot hits a body. Here's another chance for Warble. His shot stopped by Lubelcik. Two big saves there. Now finally the Pioneers clear the puck down the zone. This should be an icing. And it is. Or no, they waved it off. Okay, they thought said Gupta could have gotten to it, so no icing there, but Bedford able to get out of the zone. Gupta gets it up to Tagliaferro. Check, he evades the check, now behind the net, looking for a outlet on a centering pass. Tag still has it, wheels around, but it's blocked by a Pioneer player. Oh, the player, that's Pat Mahar, put his stick in his Tagliaferro's legs, took him down. That's going to be another penalty on the Pioneers, and Bedford goes on the power play.
This is a big moment for Bedford to expand on their one-goal lead and continue with their very dominant power play that they have.
Well, good. It was a really good play by Tagliaferro. He really drew that penalty. He took the puck into the zone, controlled it behind the net, came out in front, was able to get a shot away, got his own rebound back, or at least off the shot that went off the Trinity player, and caused the penalty there by Pat Mahar, who got a stick in his leg. So now it's a two-minute power play with 3:55 to go. From the point, Tagliaferro takes a shot. That's blocked. And Hadley kind of played back, worried about instead of covering the point, he wanted to play defense. So the puck goes all the way back into the Bedford zone. Tagliaferro picks it up, and he leads the rush back into the Pioneer end. Loses the puck. He's at the near wall. Gets it to O'Toole at the point. O'Toole waits. Down to Tagliaferro. Now all the way down low to Brian Riccio. Riccio turns around. Tags in the corner. Drifts behind the net. Gets into O'Toole. Centering passer Lobdell off his stick. Couldn't get a shot away. Riccio now behind the goal line to Lobdell. Beautiful save there by Lubelchik, and he had to fight for that rebound. Lobdell had a point-blank shot, and now there's a little bit of fisticuffs or whatever going on there behind the net with number 12, Brennan Walsh. The Bedford player trying to get the number O'Toole, got his stick up and hit him. I'm not sure if there's going to be a penalty call here. It looks like another penalty going on the Pioneers from all that. It's going to be number 9, Brady Saroy, going in, and a Bedford player going in too. It looks like Lobdell is going to get a call here, so offsetting penalties here. But another... O'Toole's going in.
Looks like we might even have a third Trinity player coming in.
So the official's trying to tamp down some of this rough stuff going on in this game, calling several penalties here. But I want to mention that Lubelchik has been amazing. He stopped Lobdell point blank in the slot, lost control of the rebound, but was able to dive on it, and that kind of precipitated the rough stuff behind the net. So yeah, it's going to be three players going into the box right now. Number 12, Brennan Walsh. Number 23, Pat Mahar, who's the original Trippy. And I can't see the number of the third player. Meanwhile, Bedford's got two players in. It's going to be Lobdell, number 10, and Parker O'Toole in the box. Officials are now talking over what the penalty call will be. Still 1:13 left in this power play. Bedford leads 2-1, 3:09 remaining in the second period. We'll hopefully get an explanation here.
This could be a big game changer for either side here, depending on how the penalties play out.
Yeah, I mean, it could be offsetting. They could be an offset here. What really depends is whether or not they call a major of some kind. You know, a 5-minute major would be an extended power play for whatever team that, you know, the opposite team, and it doesn't get called off when there's a goal scored. So we'll have to wait and see if there's any majors being called here. We'll find out here as soon as Chris Scott, our stadium announcer, tells us what the calls are. So it is going to be 5-on-4. Power play remains for the Bulldogs. 1:13 left in that power play. Face-off is to the right of Lubelchik. Bedford controls. There's Gupta at the point. Down the plant. Plant shot. Blocked by Lubelchik. Puck is loose. Jack Warble was right there, trying to put away the rebound, but Lubelchik able to cover it up quickly.
Yeah, Lubelchik's been great with rebound control tonight and making sure he gets back on top of that.
Well, he's been a little rough. He's able to get the puck is loose momentarily, but he's able to beat the Bedford players to that faceoff. There's a shot from the point, goes off a leg. Brian Riccio's shot is blocked. He goes through the crease, picked up by Plant. Plant pulls up, faceoff circle. Shot on net. Oh, that's blocked by Lubelchik. Loose. O'Connor tries to get the puck, and Lubelchik once again drops on it. So another big save there for the Trinity goalkeeper. There's 51 seconds to go here in the power play. 2-1 Bedford. We have not heard anything about the other penalties called. We're going to have to assume they might be two-minute roughs, and they'll be out of, you know, probably around the 105 mark.
Yeah, that's what it seems like.
Face-off now to the left of Lubelchik, won by the Pioneers, and it's cleared all the way down. Kerr plays it, but it's going to be Ronzello coming in to forecheck. Plant picks up the puck, skates it out of the Bedford zone. Pass across into the skates of his teammates, and Plant has to come back for it. Now Plant in the faceoff circle gets by a couple of Pioneers, saved by Lubelchik behind the net. They control it. They're trying to set up the box here. Roberto had it momentarily. Now Gupta keeps the puck in. Down low, Plant wheels around. There's a shot by O'Connor, a weak one, easily stopped by Lubelchik. 13 seconds to go in the power play. Bedford's had a few scoring chances here, but Lubelchik has been equal to everything that has been thrown at him so far.
Hopefully this penalty kill for Trinity can provide a spark in their offense for the last little bit of the second period here.
Face off to the right of Lubelchik. Scrum in the faceoff circle, picked up there by Tagliaferro. Cassidy gets it into the slot. Backhand try is blocked, and penalty has expired. Out comes number 23, Mahar, for the Pioneers, but the puck is still in the Trinity zone. Finally cleared out. And here's that Mahar right out of the box, gets a pass. Puck is bouncing in the faceoff circle. Couldn't get the shot away. I believe that was Maurice, who tried to settle the puck down, couldn't do it. Now play goes offsides at the Bedford blue line. We'll get they're going to say it was a hand pass or something, or a high stick.
Puck went out of play.
Puck went out of play, thank you. So the faceoff is in the Bedford zone. To the left of Tristan Kerr, 1:36 to go here. The four players in the box probably will have to wait for a timeout to leave the box once their time expired. Faceoff comes loose up to Tagliaferro. He's skating on one-on-one there with Leroux. Gets by him, gets a backhand on net. That was a little bit wide on the short side. Held in there by Hadley. Here's Tagliaferro. Lobdell shot is blocked. Now in the neutral zone, Tag's got to go back and play it. That's Hadley. Now Tagliaferro wheels around, got some speed. He's got Lobdell with him. Makes a move, fires, and gets a save from Lubelchik. That was a great move. Tagliaferro really picked up the speed, got by the Trinity defender, and got a nice shot away, but Lubelchik saw all the way.
Great cut across the slot between the defenders to get that shot for Tagliaferro.
Brody Plant with the face-off. Trinity wins it, though, and they fire it high into the air. Here's a race for the puck. Ronzello gets to it first, but takes a backhand that goes behind the net. And now he lays out Gupta. No call there. Gupta gets up, gets the puck back, and sends it across to his teammate, Roberto. Roberto sends it into the zone, but it's cleared out immediately. Gupta's got to get back. Now Maurice closing in on him, gets the puck out, up to Warble. Now O'Connor. O'Connor on the far wall, waiting for Warble. Decides to take a shot. That goes wide. Plant from the point. Fires. Oh, through a screen. Oh, did that go in the net? Oh, my. I think that hit the post. The post or the net?
I couldn't tell from my perspective.
It was such a screen in front of Lubelchik. Here, let's watch on the replay here. Here's the windup. Puck goes. You can see it, the way it bounced off. It must have hit the back.
I'm wondering if it hit the back bar. I didn't hear
any
post.
I don't know. It was a weird shot, but the official was in position, didn't signal a goal. So we're going to assume that it hit the post and bounced back out. Close call there for the Pioneers. Just 22 seconds left in the period. They cleared out of the zone. They have to wait for the Bulldogs to get onside. Well, O'Connor, a little eager, jumps the gun. It's going to be an offside on Bedford. 15.4 seconds to go here. Second period almost concluded. Bedford with a 2-1 lead. And they controlled play in this period. And yes, all the players are now out of the penalty box. I assume there were matching roughing calls for those four players.
That's what I would think as well.
So change of faceoff here. It's going to be O'Connor against Mahar. Picked up by Lobdell. Clears it into the Trinity end. Just 9 seconds to go here. Puck goes high into the air. Bedford controls. And there's the buzzer to end period. And that's going to do it for second period action. Just one goal in that one. Brian Riccio on a power play picks up his second goal of the game and gives Bedford the lead by a score of 2-1. I'm Harry Kozlowski here with Connor Daniels. Andrew Fenn is on camera and Dale Bird is back in the studio with the replays. We'll have third period action here in about 11 and a half minutes, so stay tuned. We're going to throw things back to the radio station quickly and then we will be right back with third period action. You're watching and listening to Bedford Hockey on BCTV and Bedford 105.1. Sullivan Arena is where we are and we're ready for third period action with the Bulldogs leading by a score of 2-1. And Connor, the story being told here by the shots on goal, we just got the stats from Chris Scott down below. It is 28 shots on goal, two goals scored by the Bulldogs. So Lubelchik is really doing his part. Meanwhile, Trinity has only gotten 12 shots on net, beating Tristan Kerr only one time in the first period. Faceoff begins and Trinity carries the puck out of the zone, but it's intercepted. Gupta took it away. Now it's slipped back into the Bedford zone. Back comes Roberto. Sends it up the walls for Tagliaferro, but taken away there by Maurice. Maurice with the wrister. Got it through a crowd, but Kerr saw it and makes a save.
That was a great shot by
Sam Maurice.
Maurice.
11.
Sam Maurice using the screen and all the people in front of the net. That was a perfectly placed shot.
He is probably their best player. Really a real speedster, too. You can see the way he cuts through players. Now Trinity controls. Here's a shot from the point. Oh, it was deflected. Speaking of Maurice again, the shot from the point by Saroy was deflected midair by Maurice, but luckily Kerr saw that and made the save.
Maurice kind of reminds me of a Joe Pavelski-esque kid. Quick with his feet, good at deflecting pucks.
Back to the point, Saroy, and again, deflection though. This time it was Connor Hurley in front of the Bedford net, and he clears it, he shoots it all the way past the net. Another shot on goal, Saroy. Kerr stops that from the point. Maurice behind the net, finally gets checked off the puck. Tagliaferro, long lead pass across ice to O'Connor, enters into the Trinity zone. Now behind the net, he's got Saroy on him. Give and go right there in front of the net. Tagliaferro couldn't get his stick on it. Chance for a shot there on net. Tagliaferro fanned. Now the puck going all the way back into the Bedford zone. Kerr has to play it into the corner. Cassidy's there. Now it's picked up by Dylan Riccio, cleared out of the zone. Picked up by Walsh. We get a whistle here. Not sure what the call is. Might have been, I don't know if it was an offside.
I'm not too sure. I missed whether it was offside or a penalty.
Yeah, I was looking at the roster at the time, but it's just a whistle, and maybe it was a hand pass or something. Puck in the neutral zone. Face-off won by Bedford. Pass across to Brian Riccio. He's been our goal scorer. He's got both goals in this contest for Bedford.
Yeah, he's been the star player tonight for Bedford.
And O'Toole, number two, he's gotten both assists. Tagliaferro got the other assist in this game. Cassidy behind his net. Up to Brian Riccio. Long lead pass to brother Dylan. A little too far. Dylan's going to have to chase it down. In the faceoff circle, pulls up, has some room. Now gets it down low to O'Toole. Back to Dylan Riccio, trying to fight off a check. Brian Riccio picks up the loose puck, gets it to the point for Gupta. Gupta gives it back to Brian Riccio. Down low to Dylan, behind the net. Dylan Riccio to the point for Roberto. Fires a wrister that goes wide. Gupta holds it in at the point. There's a shot. That goes wide. Now picked up by 16, Kinsella for Trinity. Fires a shot from the point. Easily stopped there by Kerr. Puts it into the corner. Saluto in the corner now for Trinity. He centers it, knocked away by Bedford, and over the blue line comes the puck. O'Toole picks it up into the Trinity zone. He fires it and hits number 14, Leroux, with his shot. Here's number 5, Warble. Pass across. There's a block shot, and Trinity comes back the other way. Roberto's shot is blocked. Long shot on Kerr, easily stopped. Roberto picks it up behind the net, pulls up, tries to get away from one check, winds up turning the puck over. Trinity able to get it back. They lost it now. They have to chase it back into their own end. That's Leroux. His lead pass misses everybody. Cross ice pass taken away by Trinity. Now Gupta gets the puck back. Bedford having a little trouble getting out of their zone. Great shot there by Plant. Glove saved by Lubelchik. Puck is in the corner. Long pass intended for Hadley, too far. Goes out of the zone. Roberto has to play it.
That was a good look by Bedford with the shot going off of blocker side. Look at the rebounds.
Now Brody Plant rides the puck behind the net, gets it to the point. There's Hadley shot from the point, hits a body, goes wide. On the far wall, finally cleared up to Vinzia. Vinzia over the blue line. He's got all the Bedford players in front of him. Takes a long shot, and that's saved there by Kerr. Here's another shot from the blue line. Not many shots to Trinity. They were able to score once on the power play, but really not much else on 5-on-5. Now there's Ryan O'Connor. His shot is knocked away by Lubelchik. He gets his own rebound back. O'Connor still with the puck, puts it on net. Oh, backhand by Hadley Afaro off the crossbar. Great opportunity there on a sharp angle shot. And there's a cover up there by Lubelchik, and we're going to get a whistle. But maybe we'll get a replay of that. There was O'Connor cruising along behind the net, comes out, takes a sharp angle shot, bounces up, and then Hadley Afaro backhands it off the crossbar.
That was a close call.
Great opportunity there for Tags. Face-off in the Trinity end with 10-11 to play in regulation, 2-1 Bedford. Gupta picks it up, wheels around, carries it back into the Trinity end, sends it into the corner behind the net. Lobdell's able to block it with his shin guards, backhands it for Tagliaferro behind the net. He's got O'Connor in front of the net, couldn't get it to him. O'Connor now behind the net. He takes a check there from Hurley. Tags picks up the loose puck, tries to get the centering lane, can't quite find it, loses the puck along the far wall. And now there's a turnover, one-on-one. Here's Sam Maurice coming in one-on-two. He's got the speed, gets around Gupta, and Gupta trips him. It's going to be a power play for Trinity. Maurice, you know, he accelerated right there, and Gupta just kind of fell down. I don't think he intended to trip him. He was trying to poke check him, but instead got to stick into his skates, and it's going to be a power play now on the Trinity side. You know, Sam Maurice has been showing himself to be the most dangerous player on this Trinity lineup. Every time he gets the puck, you can just see the acceleration. He makes things happen. Even though it was like a one-on-two on that play, he almost got past Gupta. Gupta had to take him down. Off the faceoff, they can't keep the puck in the zone. So they're trying to get back to it. Saluto turns it over. Dylan Riccio instead takes it back into the Trinity end. He still has the puck behind the net. Good penalty kill here. Now at the point, Cam Hadley sends it back down low. Riccio wasn't there. So Trinity has a chance to break out. Pass misses everybody. Hadley gets it. Now he fires it all the way down into the Trinity end. Here's Dylan Riccio. He overskates it. Now a turnover. Ryan Riccio tried to get to his brother, but that gets knocked away. And now here comes Saluto into the Bedford end. Now behind the net, Saluto takes a check from Roberto. He gets knocked down. But Maurice has it. Walsh fires a shot. Tried to get it across to Saluto. He couldn't get a shot away in the corner. That's Maurice. Maurice gets around one Bedford player. Now wheels around. takes a shot, hits a leg, goes wide. Here's Ronzello, the goal scorer for Trinity. Tries to get it to the point, back to Saroy, but it jumps over his stick. Everybody's got to get onside. 38 seconds left on the Bedford penalty. Saroy up to Maurice. Now to Ronzello. Ronzello over the blue line, drops it for Maurice. Probably shouldn't have done that because he had a Bedford player all over, but he gets away. Skating, looking for a shooting lane, finally finds one, but Kerr is able to glove that. Big save there by the Bedford keeper. But again, you saw the skill of Maurice, takes the puck, and he just did it all himself.
Yeah.
Carried the puck along the blue line, waited until a lane opened up to the net, fired it, but that, at that point, Kerr had everything covered up. Off the faceoff, there's a shot from the point. Hits a leg, now comes back out, and O'Connor's able to clear it out. Just 9 seconds left on the Trinity power play. Lubelchik plays it in the corner.
Big penalty kill by Bedford here.
Trinity not able to get anything going. Not like the first period. They had a really nice power play early on, but nothing yet in this one. Penalty expires. Bedford penalty is over. Everybody's back to full strength. And here's O'Connor, backs it up, tries to get the puck to Tagliaferro down low. Gets knocked into the other corner. Plant, back to Tags. Inside to O'Connor, couldn't get a stick on it. Now pass across, oh, what a save by Lubelchik. He had O'Connor wide open, but he slid across and made the save. Now Tagliaferro in the corner. Down low, looks for a centering pass, intercepted by Ronzello. Tries to send away Maurice. Maurice does come up with the puck. Here he goes, one-on-one. Maurice around one man. Fires a shot, and O'Kerr saw that and made another nice save on Maurice.
Huge save by Lubelchik at the other end. Leads to fast transition down into Bedford's end by Maurice, where he's able to get a great shot off, looking glove side, and Tristan Kerr makes an amazing glove save right there.
Kerr just saw the way the play was developing, and Maurice really, you know, had an angle where he didn't have that much net to shoot at, and Kerr was able to, you know, he had really good position, covered everything up. But I can't stop raving about the save that Lubelchik made. He sucked that pad out of nowhere and just robbed O'Connor there. It could easily be 3-1 right now. In the Bedford zone, here's a turnover, and here comes Bedford the other way. O'Toole skating into the faceoff circle high, and Lubelchik loves it.
Yeah, the save by Lubelchik, going back to that, that's the type of save that could swing the momentum of this game for the last 6:15 of the period.
I mean, Bedford's been outplaying them, but it's only a one-goal game. It's 2-1 with 6:15 to go, so Bedford has to keep the pressure up. Dylan Riccio on the faceoff. It's controlled by the Pioneers. DeFreitas takes the check. Ronzello tries to play it. Dylan Riccio in the corner comes up with the pass, gets it to Brother Brian. Up the wall. There's Roberto. Brian Riccio. O'Toole tries to center it. Oh, another great save by Lubelchik, point blank.
Unbelievable work by Lubelchik tonight.
Just great positioning right there, you know. The centering pass from O'Toole, who, by the way, has the assist on both goals, found Dylan in the slot, got it to him, but Lubelchik was ready for him. .49 to go here in regulation. Faceoffs back in the Trinity end. Ryan O'Connor. Trinity wins it, but it's held in up, not at the point. It's going to be a turnover. Here comes Sam Maurice. Takes a shot, gloved by Kerr. Drops down and covers it up. So Gupta unable to hold the puck at the blue line. Sam Maurice picks up the loose puck and with speed one-on-one fires a shot that Kerr saw and gloves it. So Kerr's having a pretty good night himself here.
He sure is.
5:38 to go. O'Connor on the faceoff here for Bedford. Early for Trinity, won by Trinity. All the way behind the net, Tagliaferro tries to get it up. Gets it to Lobdell. Lobdell's got a lane here, closing in. Faceoff circle, shot, hits the short side of the net. O'Connor closes in. Here's Tagliaferro picking up the loose puck. Backhand, tried to get it to Lobdell, he couldn't play it. In the corner, Patton, puck is swatted at. Now cleared up for Ronzello. He gets the puck. He's got Maurice with him. Ronzello in the faceoff circle fires a short angle shot. That's blocked by Kerr. Ronzello gets it back behind the net. Ronzello centers it and shot score. Maurice with the goal. It's all tied at two. Ronzello had the puck for Trinity behind the net, tried to get it out, but the pass went off the skate of Gupta right to Maurice, who had the wide open net. So Maurice finally gets his goal. He had so many shots, but he ties it up here with 4:57 to go. It's all tied at two.
Looking back at the Lubelchek save, it really, really was a very important moment, momentum swinging wise, in this game.
Yeah.
Now Trinity's back in it.
Like I said, you know, it was just a one goal game, and now we see that all you need is one opportunity. A bounce off of Bedford skate winds up on Maurice's stick, and it's in the net. All tied at two, 4:46 to go. So all the puck possession and shots that Bedford got really doesn't mean anything if they can only beat Lubelchek twice. There's a shot blocked away by Lubelchek in the corner. They take a hit, O'Toole does. Dylan Riccio just blows off Saroy off his skates, gets it to the point. Cam Hadley, shot is blocked. Now the puck goes to O'Toole inside to Brian Riccio, couldn't get a stick on it. Changes direction, still has it. Dylan Riccio, again, the puck was given kind of on his wrong side, wasn't able to get a shot away, but Trinity able to clear the zone to get a whistle, and icing faceoff will come back into the Trinity end. All tied at two, 4:07 to go. Don't forget Bomb Radio with Phil Bruno coming on right after the contest here, although it looks like we might be heading to OT if another goal isn't scored here. Off the faceoff, controlled by the Pioneers. They're behind the net, absorbing one check, and now they clear it out of the zone. Gupta tries to get it up to O'Connor. Fighting for the puck is Saluto, who brings it into the Bedford end. Saluto with Roberto on him behind the net. Roberto is able to take that puck away from him, wheels around, and carries it out of the zone. Long shot. A long clearing pass goes right to Lubelchik, is able to glove that. Puck is behind the net. Goes to Kinsella on the wall. Tagliaferro tries to hit him, but possession remains. Now Tags gets the puck back in the neutral zone, wheels around, tries to put some speed on his own. Fires a shot. Using number 12, Walsh is a screen, but Lubelchik, again sharp, makes the glove save.
That was a low and hard shot by Tagliaferro that Lubelchik was able to grab by the glove.
So the Bulldogs have to put some pressure on here to get that third goal, but they also have to be careful not to turn the puck over, not to let Maurice walk in, because he's been a threat all game here for the Trinity Pioneers. Into the corner, it's Walsh. Off the wall, and that's going to end up being an icing all the way into the Bedford zone. 3:02 to go. Next broadcast, by the way, will be tomorrow evening, 7 o'clock. It's going to be boys basketball against Wyndham. That starts at 7 o'clock. Corey Munstertiger will have the call for you. That's right here on BCTV in Bedford 105.1. Face-off in the Trinity end, controlled again by the Pioneers. Couldn't be retained at the point. It's fired into the Bedford zone. Luckily, Cam Hadley gets there first. Ronzello falls down, giving Bedford a chance to clear. This might be an icing on Bedford, and it is. So the faceoff's going to come all the way back into the Bedford end here with 2:45 left. It's hockey night in Goffstown. I mean, in Bedford, it is in Goffstown, and I should say that the Goffstown High School, the Grizzlies, they've got a game right after this one. So it's one game after another here at Sullivan Arena. Off the faceoff, goes to the point. There's a shot saved by Kerr. Walsh fired it from the blue line. Kerr saw it all the way. You can see the Goffstown team stretching and going through their motions behind the glass there. Faceoff won by Bedford. Still in the faceoff circle, though. Lobdell runs into Hurley for the control of the puck. Now here's a turnover. Maurice took it away. Now he's got it on the far wall. Hadley's trying to check him off the puck. Brian Riccio gets gets it across now to O'Toole. Two on two. O'Toole gets around his man. Cuts across. Shot scored. Once again, O'Toole gives it to Dylan Riccio. Or to Brian Riccio. Number 18, I think it was, right? It was Riccio.
It was Brian Riccio.
So a hat trick for Riccio. A natural hat trick. And a assist hat trick for O'Toole. He's got three. What a turnaround here. Two on two. O'Toole carries the puck into the zone. Uses leverage to get around to the Trinity defender. Gets a shot on a sharp angle to Belichick. Bounces off of him and goes into the net. It looks like a timeout being called by Mike Connell of the Trinity Pioneers here.
Riccio and O'Toole have a very impressive chemistry together.
They've been the effective line here today. So, like I said, you know, Bedford had to put the pressure on, and it worked. They got the goal to go ahead, but now for 2:14, they have to keep Trinity off the wall. They have to make sure somebody is on Sam Maurice all the time, because you know Maurice is going to be out there for the last 2:14. Belichick is probably going to get pulled at some point. They're going to have the extra attacker, and he's just been such a danger. They're going to have to keep him off the score sheet once again. He does have one goal. He has a tying goal, Maurice does. They don't want another tying goal.
Yeah, exactly. I think for Bedford, I think the tool to shut down Maurice is to double team in a way, right? To go, if you go to the, say he's on the boards, send in a guy to put pressure on him, and when he does his spin move, that's when you send in the guy that's already covering the point to try to take that puck and turn it into a transition towards maybe what could be an empty net.
That's true. They do have to be careful, though, to not leave anybody open unguarded, because remember, they're going to have six skaters out there to five, so if you double team Maurice, that's going to leave somebody wide open, maybe two skaters. So they got to be a little, maybe they'll just maintain the box in front of Kerr to, you know, keep anybody from getting, keep all the shots on the outside. Kerr's been seeing everything coming in from the outside. All the goals scored on Kerr today, the two, have all been inside the slot, you know, really tight goals. That last one, an unfortunate bounce off of Goof's escape right to Maurice. So here we go, face-off, center ice, 2:14 left. Face-off goes into the Trinity end. Picked up by the Bulldogs. Here's Tagliaferro. As long as they keep the puck in the Trinity zone, that's going to keep Lubelchik in his crease. Puck is loose behind the net. O'Connor gets there first. O'Connor waits. Gets it to the point to Gupta. Gupta fires a wrister. Here's the centering pass. Tagliaferro right in the slot. He gets taken down. Now here's an opportunity for Trinity coming back, and Lubelchik's heading for the net. This is Maurice. Face-off circle shot, and that's swallowed up by Kerr.
That's exactly how you want to contain Maurice. Keep him on the outside and allow your goaltender to continue to see where that puck's going to come in from.
And with the face-off, Lubelchik goes to the bench. Trinity's going to pull their goalkeeper, and they're going to put six skaters out there. It's going to be Walsh, Kinsella, Hurley, Ronzello, Maurice taking the faceoff, and number 9, Saroy. That's who's out there. Clearing attempt. That's going to be an icing call on Bedford. That was just shot off the wall. But, you know, it's not like the NHL where he can't make a change. It's worth icing the puck. Anything to keep it out of the Bedford zone. Right? I mean, any chance you get, just send it down the ice. Don't worry about giving up a faceoff.
Yeah, at this point, it's just about time management and trying to get down to the zeros on the clock and secure a win for Bedford.
94 seconds here. It's Maurice against Lobdell in the faceoff circle. Lobdell wins that one. Backhanded out of the zone. Tagliaferro forechecking a bit in the Trinity end. Fired right back into the Bedford zone. Gupta able to clear it out. Having a little trouble clearing the zone here. O'Connor comes up with it. Now Lobdell, he takes a hit. Walsh gets it up to Ronzello. Into the Bedford zone. Ronzello wheels around. It hits Gupta on the leg. Gupta's able to clear it out. That's going to miss the net. It'll be another icing call with 6:03 left. As soon as the game's over, it'll be Bomb Radio here on Bedford 105.1 if you're tuning in there.
Bedford's doing a good job keeping Trinity on the outside right now and not really giving them a whole lot of looks so far.
No opportunities in tight on Kerr, that's for sure. Dylan Riccio on the faceoff against Kinsella. Puck is dropped. Trinity wins it. There's a shot from the point from Walsh that sails high. But Maurice now behind the net. Wheels around. Takes a sharp angle shot. Misses everything. Picked up there by O'Toole. O'Toole bounces it off the wall. Tries to get it across. Tried to get it to his partner Riccio for his fourth goal. Couldn't do it. Now Ronzello skates in with Maurice. Faceoff circle. High shot off the sides of the net. Bounces off into the netting. And we get a whistle with 39.2 to go. So great play there, but the transition was quick for Trinity. They were able to turn around and get a shot on net. Kind of a dangerous play there. Now Chris Centrino against Dylan Riccio. Faceoff, puck is loose in the circle. Drop back now to Roberto. Roberto sails it high, able to be gloved by Walsh. Oh, what do we have here?
Looks like
a hand pass. Okay, so there's going to be a whistle and a faceoff. It should come out of the zone since it was Trinity with the hand pass. Yep, it's going to come out outside the blue line. Oh, it's going to go all the way back into the Trinity zone.
This is devastating if you're Trinity.
Yeah.
Having to put Lubelcheck back in the net and having the faceoff in your own zone is going to cost you a good 10 seconds of time.
And Bedford's been superb on the forecheck here, so this is an opportunity to bottle them up.
Yep.
Dylan Riccio on the faceoff here against Centrino. O'Toole picks up the puck behind the net, stops, leaves it there inside to Dylan Riccio, takes a big hit in front of the net, but Bedford still controls. 18 seconds to go. O'Toole loses the puck. Dylan Riccio has it on the wall. Just wasting time here. Brian Riccio gets a stick on it. Dylan Riccio behind the net. He's got players all over him, but still controlling the puck. 6 seconds left. Lubelcheck pushes the puck away from the crease, still behind the net. And that's going to do it. Like you said there, you know, the faceoff comes all the way back and the forecheck kills the remaining 30 seconds and just ends any kind of opportunity there for Trinity. So your final score here, Bedford 3 and Trinity 2, a great game. 3 goals scored by Brian Riccio, 3 of them assisted by number 2, Parker O'Toole, and 1 assist goes to Dom Tagliaferro. Meanwhile, on the other side, Ronzello gets the first goal in the for Trinity, and it was a power play goal, and then a second one, which is also a power play by Sam Maurice that came late to tie the game. And that is going to do it for today. Like I said, thank you very much for tuning in to our broadcast. Connor, thank you very much for joining us on the broadcast. You did great first time out.
Thank you, Bill Jennings
is here overseeing everything. Andrew Fenn is on the camera. Dale Bird back in the studio. That is your BC TV crew. We'll be back on here tomorrow at 7 o'clock for boys basketball against Windham. Make sure you tune in for that. Final score 3-2 Bedford. Thanks for tuning in, everybody.